Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is a powerful gospel because it not only tells you what Jesus Christ did in his life up to the point of the resurrection, but it tells the whole story of all of our lives. Jesus called 12 apostles to follow him, and not one person came back after he was dead and put in the Holy Sepulcher. Why? Who came? It was the women who were his followers. It was a very noble man, as it says, righteous man, Joseph of Arimathea, who was wealthy. And he decided to follow the Lord. And we look at that and we say, well, where are the rest of them? And it tells you right in the beginning, they were afraid. When Jesus goes to see them later after this gospel, when he goes and he finds them in the upper room, and he walks in, and the first thing he says to them is, peace, I give you my peace, because peace takes away fear. Peace takes away all the troubles you have. The disciples, the apostles, were afraid because they saw what happened to the Lord. He was killed, and they were Jews, and they were petrified. They were next, so they were hiding. That's our story. We met the Lord somewhere along in our lives. We were baptized, we became Christians. We were his followers. He called each of us, but we didn't make the commitment. Like the holy apostles, we didn't make the commitment to the end. We were afraid. We didn't have peace because there were other things we were deeply concerned about. Our well-being, all these things. But the ladies, the myrrh bearers, and men who were not called were there. So that tells us about our human relationships. We oftentimes make encounters with people, with God, but without a commitment, without saying, this is forever and I will follow, it disappears. How many of us in our lives have attempted to follow Christ and then at times something comes in our way and it gets lost? We say, oh yeah, I believe, but why aren't you there? Oh, well, you know, and those are the excuses we give. Love without fidelity and commitment is not love. Love that is just for now is a self-indulgent love. It's what it gives you, that's all. And so what we have to recognize is that we cannot be followers of Christ now and not tomorrow and the next day. And I will discern, I will pick and choose which parts of following him I will do. Doesn't work. You meet someone, you marry them, you fall in love, you think life is wonderful, and then illness comes, or abuse comes, or infidelity comes, and we say, it's over, I'm not going to be there anymore. I can't take it. This is not what I invested in. This is not what I thought I was getting, and therefore I am finished. I don't want to be hurt anymore. I'm closing the door and saying, too bad. That's what the apostles were doing. They ran, closed the door, and were filled with fear because what they thought they invested in, they didn't get. Because the Lord was killed, the Lord was dead, and they don't know where he is, and the women came of their own free will. And Joseph of Arimathea came of his own free will. He wasn't called by Jesus, said, I'm making you an apostle, No. They came because they believed and they saw the light Christ bore. We've got to get the light back in our lives about people we know, people we love, people we care about. If we just say, I care about you now because everything's great, or that's what I thought I wanted, that wasn't love. There's no commitment there. I will love you to the end, and we together will change and grow and become as one. So the Lord's calling you, and he's calling me. He's calling us in all our relationships to be committed, to be faithful, to see it to the end. Don't close the door and go hide, because that's not love. That's love of yourself. It's not what I bargained for. It's not what I wanted. Therefore, I'm not going to do it anymore. You go your way, I'll go mine. That doesn't work. It doesn't work. And what happens? Once we start that path, I'm angry with you. I don't want you in my life. We lose our own life. We stop having the ability to have peace. We are afraid and we lock ourselves up. Don't do it. Because Christ calls us not only to love, not only to follow, but to a full commitment unto the death and resurrection in everything we do. So be faithful. Don't be afraid. Have peace. Know that you are following the Lord who is life, who is truth, and this we are not. We are not the light, we are not the truth, and we can't give life, but he does, but only with a commitment and with steadfastness. Not, I will decide what I want from it, and I won't. I was reading just the other night, St. John Chrysostom, and St. John was saying, it's amazing how we let some very insignificant things rule our lives. He was talking to the people, and he was saying, if you don't fast, you're not Orthodox. It doesn't matter what you think, because fasting is giving that which you desire for something greater than you have. And he said, you can't decide, well, I don't like the fasting part, but I'm still with you, Lord. Or, I don't want to die with you, Lord, but when the time comes, I'll take off. But, you know, we can't pick and choose. You can't pick and choose when you love somebody. Because if you love, you get the whole package. The good, the bad, the indifferent, the weakness, the strengths, the failures, the successes, that's all part of the package. And we forget that. But the myrrh-bearing women did not forget. And Joseph of Arimathea didn't forget. They were there to see the Lord through his part of resurrection and the time he'd be there afterwards. And they were deeply rewarded because the fear was taken away. They didn't worry, am I going to lose everything I have? Is this a disaster? Should I just call it quits? They said, no, we're to the end. We're to the end. Remember that. Because the only one that loses when you don't follow your commitment is you. And then you become smaller and more angry and lacking in ability. And you begin to not judge yourself, you judge everybody else. And in the meantime, you're miserable. So the Lord says, I give you my peace. Not as the world gives do I give you peace, but I give you my peace, which is your whole life is unified in him. So today, we celebrate the myrrh bearers. And I remember one time I gave a talk at a nun's monastery. It was on the Feast of the Myrrh Bearers. And I read out the myrrh bearers and I said, and Nicodemus and Joseph of Arimathea. And the abbess came to me after and said, this is the Feast of the Women, not the men. I said, they were myrrh bearers too. No, only the women. I said, go read your scriptures. The myrrh bearers were also men. And they thought this was an exclusive women's club. You know, nobody else was in it. But the women were faithful. And it's amazing. We don't give enough credit to them because their lives were just as much in danger as the apostles. But they could not live without the one they committed to, without the one they loved. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.